Welcome to an Echo Care Guide. In this video, I'll be teaching you how to care for three species of ant queens based on my experience. We'll be covering Polyrhachis, Iridomyrmex, and Pheidole. For the first part of this video, we'll start with Polyrhachis, specifically Polyrhachis vermiculosa, also known as the golden-tailed spining ant. However, this guide applies to other Polyrhachis species as well. Polyrhachis nuptial flights are currently happening here in Australia, so if you caught a Polyrhachis queen, this guide will help you care for and raise her successfully. Polyrhachis vermiculosa queens are grey with an iridescent orange or golden gaster. They're medium-sized, with queens reaching around 10mm in length, and workers typically between 5 to 7mm. The queen has an extremely bulky thorax with clearly visible wing scars, while males are all black and have a thin wasp-like frame. These ants are semi-claustral, meaning they require food during the founding stages and need some space to move. I prefer to set up the test tube with only 1/3 water instead of the usual 2/3 or half, as excessive humidity can cause issues like fading of the beautiful golden gaster. These queens are not too picky in the founding stage and usually lay their first eggs quickly. They drink a lot and the abdomen swells up after consuming sugar water. A single drop of sugar water is enough to stimulate egg laying, and once the first workers on anatics hatch, they'll require protein. The wait for anatics can be frustrating, as they take around 2 months to close, but the effort is definitely worth it. I would rate Polyrhachis queens a 2 out of 5 in difficulty. The slow development and relatively high mortality rate make them a more challenging species to raise, but they are highly rewarding once established. Now let's move on to the next species, Iridomyrmex. This is one of the most popular and fastest growing genera of ants. For this section, I'll be using Iridomyrmex bicknelli as an example, but the same care applies to most species in its genus. Iridomyrmex workers are tiny and thin, with a fully black body apart from the red jaws. The queens are all black with a massive iridescent abdomen and a small head and thorax. These ants are fully claustral, meaning they don't require food during the founding stage. They prefer small enclosed living spaces that mimic their natural founding chambers. I set up the test tube with 2/3 water to maintain proper humidity. They thrive in darkness and should be left undisturbed in a cool, dark place until the nematics hatch. Since they're fully claustral, they do not need any food until the first workers arrive. Once nematics hatch, usually within a month, they drink sugar water and accept protein such as insects or fruit. These ants are low maintenance and can develop quickly with minimal effort. I would rate Iridomyrmex a 5 out of 5 due to the ease of care. They're extremely active, entertaining to watch, and easy to maintain. Their fast growth and resilience makes them an excellent choice for both beginners and experienced ant keepers. Finally, we have Pheidole, commonly known as the big-headed ants. I'll be using Pheidole megacephala as an example. These ants are visually striking due to their large-headed major workers that appear later in colony development. The nuptial flight season has recently ended, so if you manage to catch a queen, here's how to care for her. Pheidole workers are small, reddish-brown, and have a very thin petiole connecting the thorax to the abdomen. Queens, however, are around the size of a Polyrhachis worker, with a diamond-shaped thorax and a plump red abdomen. Majors, which make up about 1 in every 100 workers, have massive heads filled with muscles for cracking seeds and defending the colony. These ants require test tube setups with 2/3 water, similar to Iridomyrmex. They prefer darkness and should be kept in a cool, dry place. Like Iridomyrmex, Pheidole queens are fully claustral and do not need food during the founding stage. Once the nematics arrive, typically about 1 month, they will eagerly drink sugar water and consume protein. However, Pheidole colonies can be picky with food. They tend to reject the same protein if offered too many times in a row, so variety is important. that wraps up this Agri Care Guide. Whether you're raising Polyrhachis, Iridomyrmex or Pheidole, I hope this video has helped you understand the needs and given you the knowledge to care for your queen successfully.
Let me know in the comments what species you're currently raising, and if you found this guide helpful, consider subscribing for more ant content. While you're at it, why don't you check out my favorite video? Thanks for watching!